Welcome back. Hope you're doing okay and following along. If you have any questions, feel free to let me know. So let's get cracking. Alrighty. So I've let the eyes dry. I'm going to let them dry a little longer. Meanwhile, I'm going to do the back, fill that in with a base color. And this base is going to be a mix of cadmium orange hue and the mix of cadmium red hue. Since this little guy is a Sheltie with some orange fur. All right. So I'm going to put that in here, get this activated. Okay, I'm using cadmium orange hue. I'm activating the color right now and putting it onto the palette. You can see the difference using a ceramic or porcelain slash non-plastic palette. The difference is actually very noticeable. Just to show you, I'm going to put it on the plastic and you'll see how it beads up and kind of pools like that. It doesn't do the same, it just kind of shrinks and leaves some weird separations. So that's why if you have access to a porcelain, non-plastic, and ceramic palette, you'll notice you can get some pretty good spread going on. Okay. Now to pull the color from this. Don't need a lot. I just want to darken, add some of this to my orange there. Just to bring it in, let that mix up a bit. Let it soak up into the brush, see how it's going right in. Okay, I'm gonna put that down here. The longer you let the water sit on top of your cake, the more pigment's going to be infused into the water. So I'm just kind of letting it melt in. All right, that's good. And there we go. That's the color I was looking for, but I'm going to leave this pure and over here pure so I can pull in some color lighters. All right, so this color goes here and in the back, and I'm going to bring it a little bit into the face area. Get some water. Just putting a base down. Actually, it helps sometimes. Oops. There's a whoops. If you wet the paper a little bit and let it spread that way. orange in here. Color through. Letting it mix in with the sepia that I have. I'll let it go on in a dry, let it dry out, bring it through. More water over here. That's where I'm going to pick up some of the lighter colors, because he gets a little lighter down in here. Bring that over, let it mix in. I'll end up, this is just going to be your end, your base color, the undercoat, so to speak, pun intended. Alright, what do we got here? He's got a little bit of color over here. Into white. Alright. And I'll bring a little bit of this over here. This will tie all this together. I'm using my number 4, as you can see. Establishing some tone to bring it all together. Just a tiny bit there. More over here. This will dry a little lighter. And as it's drying, I'm bringing in some fur strokes. As you can see, that bled a little bit here. That's okay. That can be cleaned up. That's by pulling it out, as you can see. All right. Introducing some of the orange into the previously dark color I placed down. And it'll dry a little darker. Oops, there's a whoops. I'll have to fix that. As you can see, happens. Before this sets in totally, let's pull that up. So remember, I showed you, get it wet, let it kind of work its way through, and then hard dab. Hard dab, that pulls that right up. All right. So that's good for now. I'm going to let this dry. This will probably take about, where I did a little extra water here, probably about 30 minutes or so to dry. So I'm going to be working on Cameron again. Taking a little bit of the rose permanent rose. I'm going to just add a little bit of it into the air. There's just a tiny bit. Just enough. Very subtle. There we go. That area dry a little bit. Go back into the nose. Again, using reference, just reshaping the nose area. Didn't quite like that before. It's more of a top-down view. I'm going to be introducing a little bit of darker. Just wanted to get that in place. coming into the upper air location. Let's spin this so I don't put my hand in. Should have gone with this ear first. Making a dark color here. This is actually, what am I using on this one here? Prussian blue and sepia. You'll notice when you're painting, you tend to be a little quiet. I'm just going in through here. I just want to tone this a bit. Yeah, it's all building up in layers. Some more of my black going dark using blue. Let this get activated. Drop some water in it. Get as much pigment out as I can with the amount of water. Let's go with burnt umber. Activate my burnt umber. There we go. See how it's getting nice and dark. and start working in some more of the darks. Yeah, just brushing long furred pets, animals. You got longer sweeping strokes. And this little guy has got a lot of long fur. I'm just building up layers. Water. Use your swatch just to see. Okay, that's gonna work. Basically building, going along the fur line, blending, having it look like it's actually fur. Just going with the flow, so to speak. some of this over since it's wet. Again, it's building layers. The more you go over, the darker it'll get. Light strokes, barely touching in some areas, just to it's just building up the layers for showing the fur direction. You heard that little squeak? That was Dory, my cat, my calico, being harassed by Izzy at the moment. Having the orange base underneath, you want to have some of that show. There, I'm just establishing the fur pattern that I'm going to follow up with some on the darker orange. This will create some shadowing. Here, get some more brown going. So not doing very wet. It's a kind of a dry brush technique going on here so that I can, it'll dry quickly enough. That way I can come back over and lean on it, so to speak, as you can see. I'm going to test that before you do it. For here, I'm going with my Wisp brush. Get some finer fur strokes going. Spin this. Just barely touch. Try and get some subtle brush strokes of fur in here. Notice how putting it down just to try and get the brush strokes of the fur, and then I'll just dab it a little bit, pull up some of the color. You gotta be careful when you're doing something like what I'm doing here. See how it's pulling up some of the other color and kind of making it look a little washed out. Just gonna, again, do layers on that. I'm building up the darks there. If it's wet like that, you just kind of go over it, let it bleed dry. again, spinning it. Getting some fur patterns going. Blowing on it to dry a little bit. Yeah, I'm jumping around, I get it. Yes. Go where you feel you need to go. Here, get a little more water. Need some water. dabbing off on my paper towel, which is becoming multicolored. Just establishing some fur lines. Not to be confused with felines. I believe this is my Payne's gray that I put there. I'm going to put some more sepia down. Oops. From the tube. And my paint's gray. I'm going to put a little more of that down. Go a little darker. I'm coming down to more blacks, darks, down in here. I'll jump to the nose. Izzy, no. Let's throw down a little bit more of a base. I'll be coming back in with some darks to really darken that up. Meanwhile, I'll get a little more water. Bring that up. Blend it in at the base. Really thin wash with the gray color. Really get it soupy. Lift up some of this to be more gray. I'm gonna come back in with the darks. Bring in some more fur lines. That's good for now.